Hello, everyone. Hoot hoot, everyone. It's me, Ethan, that there Turbo Owl. And I'm just here with a bit of an old, I guess an impressions. And this time... Oh, the music's gone again. We're going to be playing Crow Country on that there PC. If you don't know what Crow Country is, it is a recently released, by which I mean the music did go away while I double check this, by which I mean, like, so recent released, I believe it literally came out yesterday. Yep, the 9th of May. A recently released survival horror game, obviously very retro-inspired. I was trying to figure out what the aesthetic is. For some reason, my first go-to was, like, Animal Crossing, but then I saw the Boulder Punch video where he actually described it perfectly. It's Final Fantasy VII. It's a survival horror game. It's like Resident Evil slash the first Silent Hill style of survival horror game with the aesthetic, with like the graphical style of Final Fantasy VII. That's all I know about it. I watched a 10-minute review, which didn't spoil much, but said it was a, said it looked good. Then I found out that it hadn't actually come out yet, and then I got a review code. So, yeah, let's give it a go. I know very little about this game. We're going in blind, as one should with a horror game. Actually, if it's a horror game, should I go one step further and turn my lights off? You know what? Fuck it. Since I'm being a silly pro. I mean, I've even literally only put my goddamn face on the camera again, just for the expressed purpose of the fact that I'm. Just for the expressed purpose of the fact that. Tim, why's your toy there? Just for the expressed purpose of the fact that I'm being happy about the fact that my holiday has begun. So fuck it, may as well. If I can actually sit properly. Okay. Right. Select a game mode, survival horror exploration, but you will not be attacked. Experience the game free. Okay, that's a bit odd. That's a bit weird. Also, one of the fun things that I've not experienced for a while, because I, you know, obviously had a goatee for a good while. I didn't have the full beard until recently again. Is that when I look directly forward in the dark, my face looks like it's floating. Like, it's hard to figure out where my t-shirt ends and my face begins if I'm doing that. Okay. Well, no. We're gonna be doing survival. How did I get something in my eye in the second it took for me to get up? Like, what the fuck is going on? Alright.
Crow Country.
No? Okay. I don't know, it just always feels appropriate. Whoop. What the fuck? Oh, whoa, 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 whoa. Whoa, 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 what? Hang on, what the fuck? Ooh. Ooh, what's happening? Yes, it's into it. No, it's set. Shut up. No, okay. I don't know. I don't think that looked like anything weird happened for you guys, but the resolution just, shat itself for a second there. And it's now, like, a weird, much smaller resolution on my main monitor. We will attempt to fix this. Okay, I mean, alright. The problem is, I actually missed what you said your name was. This is the central problem. So you've just said, don't mess it up, make sure you get it right, and I already have gotten your name wrong. I've forgotten your name. I'm sorry. The resolution frightened me. The true horror is a sudden, unexpected change in resolution. The true terror. The real Dark Souls begins here, as it were. Okay. Settings, graphics, windowed full screen. What? Okay. Are you being serious? Ah, fuck off. It's not it doesn't have borderless. Oh, for fuck's sake. Okay, well, it's immediately pissed me off by doing that. That's a bad fucking first impression that it defaults to, like, I don't even know what resolution it's defaulting to, but it's defaulting to a small resolution and doesn't have an option to change it. Change resolution. No, there is no way to change the resolution. That sucks. Oh my god, that sucks. Because, this genuinely means that I either have to play it in windowed mode, or I can't see OBS. Because if I try to... Because if I set that to full screen... It makes my other monitor freak the fuck out and dumps half my desktop over there. So if I full screen that there and then I try and full screen this here. Okay, so it will show me the chat, but now the chat has been put like to a huge ludicrous size on my other monitor. This is 7 different types of fucked. This is so... this game... Bad first impression. Oh! Okay! It's calmed down now. Alright. We just had to fuck with its settings. Not even fuck with its settings. Just basically, tab out and tab back in again about 5 fucking times before the game had... I was excited to play this and the game has pissed me off immediately. Alright. Do I have a sprint? Okay, yep, got a sprint. Okay, let's try to move beyond that and also try to not look too much at the Vector Man looking ass joints on this woman. Would those be the crows whose country this is? Okay. The padlock looks a little rusty, probably break with enough force. I better go open the trunk of my car. Okay, game, if you want. Okay. Oh, it's my police file. Oh, I should probably this might help. Give me a little bit of context for what's going on. Missing persons report. Atlanta. Oh god, Atlanta. as if I have any opinion of Atlanta. Sorry, it's in my D&D group now, I just automatically react with disgust to any place name set in America just to annoy them. It's bleeding out of my fucking D&D group. Atlanta Police Department. Okay, I can't go, ugh, police. 251 Lakewood Way. Atlanta. Gah! 303, whatever. Name, Edward Crow. Okay. 57 meters. Jesus Christ, that's a bit... Oh, man, I understand. Occupation, company owner / landowner. Ah, parasite, understood. Health condition, Okay, the use of the term parasite there just fucked me up. Because I'm making a joke about landlords, but I've been reading the Bioshock novel. Oh dear. Last seen by Mr. Tolman, 42 male, last known whereabouts, Crow Country Estate. He looks like he escaped out of the fucking Walton files, but alright. Reported by Natalie Crow, 27 female, relation to missing daughter, relation to missing daughter, reported to Detective Harrison James. Okay, it's just him. It's just him. Alright. It's my car. I'll leave it here. Driving it further in could be dangerous. Yeah, you wouldn't possibly need a car in this full game. Trunk of my car. Something important stored in here. Open it up. What we got? My box of handgun ammo. Yep. Okay, yep. I have enough. Are you sure? Okay, I'm gonna be... Can I close the trunk? No, just gonna leave that there? Alright. Single shot should do it. Okay. Whoa! Oh! Oh, that's unexpected. Oh. Oh my. I thought this was gonna be an isometric experience. I thought this was gonna be a fixed camera situation. I was not prepared for full camera control. Oh no, wait, the fucking Boulder Punch review mentioned this. The game's kinda odd because you've got for lack of a better term, more modern controls with like the thumbstick, right? Right? You know, standard controls, and then you've got like the camera controls here. But on the D-pad, it's tank. The D-pad puts it into tank controls. Like you could use tank controls with the D-pad or more modern controls with the thumbstick. Which is, I mean, I'm probably gonna use this one rather than the tank controls, but it's an interesting, you know, it's a fun little nod there. Oh, yeah, sorry, I keep forgetting, I'm supposed to shoot it, sorry. Yep, okay. Ooh! Oh! Oh, that is a lot more aiming than I was expecting we'd be doing, okay. That is a lot more specific aiming. I have got zero aim. Oh. Oh, A is reload, B is fire. Okay. Hey, can I get just a little bit... I have enough? Okay, well, okay. I guess it doesn't want me going in with a full inventory, I guess. The fuck are you looking at? The fuck are you looking at? You weird little prick. I have no intention of buying a ticket. Ooh. One thing I will say about this place, these tickets have always been pretty cheap. And yet you won't buy one. Bit rude. What's that? It's a pocket light. Looks like someone dropped it. Fucking mine. Oh, it's such a simple graphic style. And yet it's not on the model. Oh, hello. Oh, hello. Okay. It's a trash can. It's full of trash. Yes, get all up in there. Yep, full med kit in the trash can, as you would. Wait, oh wait, what's this? It's a diagram of a video game controller. Fucking shut up. Fucking die in a hole. I could check this in the pause menu as well. Just a diagram of an entire PS2 controller. Fantastic, there's nobody here. Oh, even though these are, like, basically the same thing as the other one, it's actually different text. Oh, what's up? Oh, shit! It's a page from a magazine. You can hold down B or right trigger to run. Oh, that! You know what? That is a fair point. Fair point, game, actually. Thanks for telling me that. Using right trigger does allow me to also still control the camera. This is actually a lot more, like, movement than I was expecting to be getting from this kind of game. Rotate, also the camera. Okay. Okay, in we go. Into the horror of the Derpy Birds. I can tell already that I'm gonna, look at it. Fucking look at him. Ah! That's the noise that face is making. Ah! It's just, oh god. It's full of trash! Another medkit. People, no respect for medkits, these people. When shooting your bullets will do more damage if you're close to the enemy, so attempt to shoot enemies from far away will use your ammo supplies more quickly. Ah, I see. You're giving me a reason to... Can I... No? Can I... Ah! I appear to have hurt myself. Okay. Maybe I shouldn't have done that. I'm not doing great. Oh, is that just a box of handgun ammo? Fucking fantastic. You know, that's my favorite... That's my favorite thing in, you know, I remember Oh, this sucks. Can I just, before we go, can I just say, this sucks. This is a bad vibe. Bad energy. Bad vibes. I don't like it. Okay. Oh, boy. Yeah, it's my favorite thing about amusement parks is whenever I've been to, you know, Alton Towers or whatever, just the handgun ammo on the floor. Yeah, I'm gonna just turn that off. Agent Mara Forrest saves the day once again. Excellent. Very good. It's a laser sight for a handgun. Take that. Yeah. Is that automatically? Oh, it's automatically on. Okay. Not sure. Not really sure what effect that has, but alright. I don't need to go right now, thankfully. Well, we're checking every turret I've played. That's a rib cage. Something in here, but I can't get out. It's blocked by Pavel Bones. I'm going to use the ID card. Okay. You're not gonna question the bones in the turlet. It's a magazine. Beyond Magazine, August 1987, strange sighting at abandoned theme park. Aspiring paranormal photographer Arthur Mole sent in a Polaroid he took while exploring the abandoned amusement park, Crow Country. Could this thing possibly be real, or is it just another hoax? Here at Beyond Also, I can hear that, and I'm choosing to not think about it. Or is it just another hoax? Here at Beyond Magazine, we're not convinced. Try a little harder next time, Arthur. Cool, so that's gonna be something that's gonna try and eat us at some stage, right? Oh, I'm not a fan. Okay, well, I'll leave you to that one, buddy. Vending machines, trash cans, refrigerators, the supplies running, that you can get handgun from the trunk of your car. Ah, oh, cool. I'm just gonna leave that how it is. Just leave that there. That's not my problem yet. Abandoned backpack. UFO tour, 1988. Wait, but I thought this place was abandoned by 1987. It's empty. Did someone lose this? Why would there be a backpack with something from the... Hi, yep. Some kind of dead animal? I can't make out any features. Well, yeah, it's been eaten by fucking crows. It's a door. There's a bronze keyhole. I do not have a key. Gift shop. It's a door. It's locked from the other side. Well, fuck you too, buddy. That's an explosive barrel. That is... an upsettingly it's a big crow! Hello, Mr. Crow. I'm looking for your boss. Do you know where he is? Okay. Well, I'm glad she could be- Is that a fucking bear? I'm not standing in a bear trap. Why is there a goddamn bear trap? There's something wrong with the ventilator in the fairy pond area. We think something might have crawled on the pipe and died. Don't run the ventilator, and if you do, hold your breath. Seriously. Is this locked? Silver key. Oh, silver key handle. Hood furnished by exploding red barrels. Similarly, some of the electrical generators found on some walls. Yeah, it's for dealing with enemies. Okay, I don't have any change. Kick it! Kick it! Kick it! Okay. Just a bottle of antidote. Is that normal in America? You just have bottles of, like... anti-venom just in your trash cans. Just your garbage collections. Fuck. All right. Humanoid enemies will take more damage if you get a headshot. Headshot also has a chance of decapitating some enemies. You know, this is a pretty grim messaging for a fucking kids theme park. Let me tell you. You hiding in there, buddy? You have 10 credits remaining. Would you like to hear your fortune? Yes. Talk to the tree fairy to enter the fairy pond. That's not really a fortune. There's nobody I have to call. Okay. Saving. I gotta assume saving's like a manual thing. Wait, is that more ammo? Fucking shotgun shells. What the fuck is going on in this fucking place? I mean, I know it's just, I know it's just the conceit of, like, the genre that they're just being ammunition lying around. It's just, Oh, fairy tale town. Ooh, I don't like that it's wiggling. Don't like that that's wiggling. A large med kit. Ooh, nice. Ah, piss. Just a second. It has just occurred to me that this is a classic survival horror style title, which means that there is a very serious chance that the game may require me to keep track of things. Oh my god. This has still got notes from old, like, reviews I was gonna make. Oh my god, and instructions on how to do my job at work. Fascinating, okay. Remembered I'm getting chicken lo mein for dinner tonight. I am having whatever bullshit I have in the freezer. That's what I'm having. Although, when my sister gets back from her holiday, we are having a big Chinese, so I look forward to that. Okay, so what was it? I'm realizing the fact that I'm writing with my big stupid rings isn't ideal. A succulent Chinese meal, yeah. A meal? A succulent Chinese meal? Yeah. Is that 2106? Actually, you know, I'm gonna... keep this here, I'm not using the mouse anyway. A meal? A succulent Chinese meal? 2106, I think it's written in blood. Is it a code for something? Nah, it's just, it's Jean Valjean's cousin. Is this a real door? Open it. It's locked, but there's no keyhole. What about that little post box? It's a bronze keyhole. I do not have a bronze key. A lot of fucking keyholes. I could have sworn I saw another bit of ammunition lying around here. Oh wait, is that another fucking med kit? Well, the game's being relatively generous with random gubbins so far. We haven't even set, yeah, go up the set of stairs, shall we? We haven't even met a met any threats as of yet. It doesn't turn. Strange mechanical swan head. Do I need to put something in its mouth? Atlanta Globe, May 1986. Crow Country theme park opening soon. Fuck, it was abandoned by 1987. Like, this place did not last long. Cancel your weekend plans with the in-laws and grab your sunglasses. A brand new theme park is opening just a few miles southeast of Atlanta. Explore Fairy Tale Town, Haunted Hilltop, and Ocean Kingdom at Crow Country, which promises a day full of fun and adventure for the whole family. The park is owned by one Mr. Edward Crow, a lifelong Atlanta local and landowner. Yes, that's right, it appears he named the park after himself. He's a smug cunt, is Mr. Edward Crow. Not much is known about Mr. Crow, other than vague, unsubstantiated reports he is exceptionally wealthy. Nonetheless, we look forward to seeing what Crow Country has to offer when it opens its gates this summer. If a swan breaks down, just take the egg out of its wheel system. Doing so disrupts the radio signal, unlocks the wheel. Until you can get a mechanic out to fix it. Ah, okay, so we need to get an egg, I guess? It's a wheel, pretty sure it's broken. Can I take That oh, I was really hoping I could take the egg. Not the egg, the thing head. So the eggs are going missing. I think the kids are stealing them. Luckily, it turns out you can use anything as long as it's about the right size and shape. Weird, I'd assumed the eggs were magnetic or something, but apparently not.
Egg. For swan ride.
Okay. I just want to have a chance of remembering anything that I'm supposed to be doing. That this is always a problem in like survival horror style games. I end up like or any kind of games or puzzles in them, as I just end up forgetting what I'm doing. I fucking see that. Okay, you know what? Here's the thing. I think this is like. Ah. Ooh, cool. That's another thing. Do I have like a limited inventory, or I mean, it looks like I do. Oh, wait, is that another thing I can read? You get poison, use an antidote as soon as you can. Large med kits also contain antidotes, but you may wish to use them sparingly. Yeah, I'd want to use a large thing if I got, you know, seriously hurt. I mean, that's got to be 2106, right? Oh no, it can't be, because there isn't a zero. Ugh, fuck. That's a giant mushroom. It's a bit more than that. Doesn't look very happy. Is this a door? I can't see a way to open it. Would you want to open it? I mean, it looks a bit rough. I think it's broken. Look at the photo. Not great. Yeah, not great. Something in here. It's a wooden carving of a woman. She's facing the other way. Oh, there's an injured man. Don't worry. I'll get to you in a sec, bud. It's just trash, a soda can. Wait, do I have that in my inventory? Okay, no, it's just, okay. I was gonna say, am I carrying a soda can around? Sir, what happened? What, who? My name's Mara Forrest, I'm here to help. They attacked me, all I wanted was proof. What's your name? Arthur Mole. Ah, the guy from the newspaper, not the newspaper, from the magazine. Just needed a better, a clearer photo. Photo of what? Who attacked you, Arthur? Those things, I don't know. Those people, they saw me and... Alright, stay calm. You're bleeding quite badly. I should help him. What did you say your name was? Mara. Come on, I think we should take a look at your leg. Give him a healing item. Give him a med kit. Thanks. I still feel kind of bad. Come on, let's move you somewhere safe. You don't look too heavy. I don't know where we can move him. Oh, moved him to the car. He'll be safe there for now. Okay, cool. We did a good deed! Fuck, I almost ran directly onto that fucking thing. Oh, he was on top of something. Tree Lady 3184. Okay. Well, am I just running past her? Yes, I'm just running past her. 3-1. No. 3-1-8-4. Cool. Thanks for turning around. I think I remember. You have to talk to her. There's some kind of phrase you had to say. I don't remember what it was, though. Okay. Well, I assume this is going to be information we get from somewhere else. So we can continue looking around. Old cigarette, I'm not allowed to smoke. Says who? Human items to take more. Headshot, yep, this I already know. When shooting. Getting a lot more. Read the staff members posted around walls. In every save room, there's a book containing all the staff members you've read so far. Oh, the staff memo. Okay, that. A lot of staff memos about shooting people, I'm noticing. What's this? Okay. Oh. Oh. All right. Okay. No. Ouch, shit. God, I'm almost dead immediately. I'm immediately not very good at this. Shit. I wasn't expecting them to dodge. Ugh, it smells so bad, like an infected wound. I feel bad killing it, but I feel bad leaving it alive, too. That one had tuts. Okay, alright. Alrighty then. Yeah, I feel like seeing them before they can see you, sniping is a good shot. A note to the lid. Ship to Marvin Trumbull in Brazil. Samples of geological interest. It's full of rocks. Each one is bedded with pieces of shiny metal. Is this a crate full of gold ore? Can I ask why the dig site access is that cute little house? Do you think there's a chance that some kid would want to go looking in there? At the very least, let's keep it locked by the keyhole in the mailbox. Okay, yep. Wait, really? They have to go through the Okay. The fire marshal was here this morning, said the farmers are doing inspection. Crow's Lounge model railway submarine. Crow's off just to replace the Ocean Kingdom storeroom door. Aww. I didn't get a prize. Minding your own business, the economics of the mining industry, Joseph J. Carden. Is that okay, that's that. Mining's evidently a thing. Wait, hang on. Okay, I think that was just the light being weird on that. Remember to get into the fairy pond area, say this out loud to the fairy. Hear me, oh great fairy of fairest forest. It's pretty sensitive, it won't work if you have an accent. Sorry, Diego. Fairy, the one that, okay, couldn't hurt to try, cool. It's a magazine, it's a collection of video game tips. Yep, staff memos. Which I think means this must be a safe room. Large med kit, thank you. It's a ring-bound book. Oh no, that's the staff memos, okay. It's an ashtray, suppose this whole place isn't burned down. It's a cabinet, there's a keypad down here. I mean, fuck, it might, you never know, 210, nope, it can't be 2106, there's still nothing on it. Tolman's Records, March 21st, 1988. Monday morning, driving to work, boss calls into my car radio. He doesn't normally do that, something's obviously gone wrong. A true alarm going off in the second unit, boss thinks there's someone down there. Get to work, check the security camera, someone is down there, he's standing right by the pool, the security doors down at the pool are locked. Check security records, doors untouched since 6 p.m. on Friday, alarm has only just been triggered. I turn on the intercom, try to communicate, no response, but I can hear the sound he's making. Something is wrong, his clothes don't fit him, something is very wrong. Yeah, it's not sounding great. Some more fucking gold ore on the ground as well. It's a fireplace. It's cracking softly, snowing the flames. I feel something. It's a curious mixture of hope and dread. Maybe everything will be okay, and maybe it won't. Saving! Okay, I'm gonna be honest. If I had to guess, I was gonna say that the sofa would have been the save point. Legal summons. Dear Mr. Crow, I'm writing to you in relation to the incident which occurred within your theme park in July of 1988. As you know, a 15-year-old girl by the name of Elaine Marshall was injured. The incident occurred within your premises and with working hours. As such, the Marshall family is holding your person responsible. Your presence is required in court. We expect to hear from you immediately. It's a map! Ah! We've acquired a map! Oh, the glitters, history of the Gold Rush. A lot of books on the Gold Rush. Okay, just save that again after I got the map. Cool. Oh wait, I just saw another fucking medkit on the way out. Also, those motherfuckers put monsters between me and the fucking first save room. That's a fucking asshole. Thank you. Yeah, fucking! Oh wait, these are fucking enemies? Attacked by little bastard spiders now? That start was so wonderfully genuine. Shut up, Walt. Oh, good. No, good. No, no. More of them, please. Oh no! Oh good. I'm you know what, I'm just not getting close to that. Cheers. All that, actually, I'm just gonna try to, I was reading about this earlier. Hear me, oh great fairy, fairest forest? Excellent, welcome child, will you protect our precious natural world? I will! Follow me! Cheers, love. I've never been startled by anything, I don't know what you're talking about. Let's seek the truth, stare into the pure reflective pond. Water of fairy pond. Alright, it's filthy. Excellent, very good. It can be tightened. Is that gonna hurt me? So the guy who fixed the water filter did it by running through the air ventilation. So if you run the filter pump behind the curtain with the incorrect pressure, it'll trigger the ventilator. You can tighten up the pressure using the valve. Ah, I see. Okay. So now we've got to wait for the... Fucking got myself hurt again! Okay. Just nearly poisoned myself, but that's fine. It's fine, I just poisoned myself horrendously, it's fine. It's reflecting poison. Oh, God damn it. Does it need me to fucking shoot something? Ah, I don't have any ammo. I'm supposed to shoot stuff with no ammo. Handgun bullets? Fucking excellent. Right, let's go fucking blast that little target into Kingdom Come. Right. Oh, hello. She's holding a key. A bronze key. Thank you, fairy. I don't know precisely why this bronze key, which I believe leads to the mining operation, would just be handed out to kids, but okay. Is there something I can move, or is... No. God, sorry, that buzzing is right in this ear, and it scared the shit out of me for a second. Who took the Ocean Kingdom restaurant Trident? That thing's expensive. Without it, we can't do the Happy Birthday Sea Monster song. Someone said they saw it in the Witchwood. I'd go check, but that place gives me the creeps. Honestly, this whole fucking place is giving me the creeps. Here's something behind it. Oh. More shotgun shells. We do like shotgun shells. Just gonna... No, okay. I didn't think that was gonna work, but it's because the kids yearn for the mines. Oh. Oh, but, alright, see ya! Survival horror game. Running past things. Not an unreasonable thing to do. They yearn for the mines! Use the bronze key. You know, I'm gonna go back to my car, actually, see if I can't really quick get some more ammunition before I go any further. I'm not a big fan of almost any of these sounds. Bad energy, those sounds. Bad vibes. Hey, how's it going? How you doing? I'm okay. You can be honest, your leg hurts pretty bad, right? Yeah, it's throbbing, it feels weird. You have a headache? Feel kind of queasy? I don't know. The thing that hurt you, it hurt me too. Not the exact same one, but still. Do I need to go to the hospital? Mara? Just sit tight, alright? You'll be safe in the car. It's not what you want to hear, is it? Oh, you have enough. Fucking god damn it, woman. Oh, is that Elaine? Is that like... Feels weird, the transformation has begun. Yeah. I suspect that is the indication. That is what is implied. What is making this horrible sound? Bad sounds, bad vibes. Okay, what we got here? Collection of video game tips. Cool. Douglas Pike, The Builder. Natalie Crow, Autumn's Child. The computer system in both the railway room and the dungeon, I need security register access. I know it's inconvenient, but these are new regulations. Ah, computer. Access denied. ID card? No. I mean, it presumably needs that disk. It's the sun. A fire is crack. Oh, this is a safe room! It's a notebook. Tolman's Records, March 23rd, 1988. The intruder is contained in the lab. Boss is calling him the guest. I told him that was in poor taste, but it stuck. Offered guest food and water. Took no notice of either. I can't begin to describe what's wrong with him. Boss doesn't want to call an ambulance. Doesn't want to call anyone. I suggested we shut down all root excavation just until we work out what's happened. Boss says we can't shut down just yet, so the machines are back on. I have a bad feeling. I think we're about to make things worse. Cool, so that's what's at the heart of this root thing, presumably. Okay, yeah, the game... Oh! Sick. Edward Crow, the Trailblazer. Tolman, the Mole. Bazinga, okay. More ammo! You gotta spend ammo to make ammo, or you know how it is.
You get the vibe. You know how it is.
Like, it's a bad sound, Matt. Do that. Right. Oh, I hate him. Oh, I fucking hate him. Oh, you suck, my guy. Ah, you're still up. All right. Oh, he was the entire source of that horrible sound. Okay, good. Good. No, I was... Yeah, I was really hoping that he was going to be the source of that terrible noise. Glad that we sourced that horrible sound. Glad we figured that one out. Okay. Wait, did I run past the... Shit! The children yearn for the mines! Okay, we got... Fucking chain just move. Okay, let's not worry about that right now. If you can't find the crank handle, it's because I borrowed it. I used it to hide that big egg-shaped ruby inside the haunted manor. Afterwards, I locked the crank inside a safe in the southeast utility corridor. The mechanism is incomplete. It's a pipe valve, it's missing the handle. Here's something down there. Oh, this sucks. This entire room sucks. Cool. This entire fucking room blows. Small tank of gasoline, excellent, very good. Tallman's records. We hired a company to start excavating and didn't get a plan. Problem one, they spent too long setting up. Problem two, there was already a paper trail forming and the whole point was to do this quickly and quietly. Then the deal breaker, they started asking questions about the roots. They wanted to know the full size and shape of the thing they were excavating. They wanted to know what it was made of. They wanted to know how long it had been there. No deal, obviously. They had to go. Yep, good to know this was all nice and above board and safe and cool and good. Cool. It's weird. It's not quite Final Fantasy VII. Yeah, it's not like one-to-one, but like Final Fantasy VII is the closest like immediate aesthetic comparison I could think of. A theater. Can't get inside. Okay. Did we go this far? I don't think we went beyond this point. Cosmic future coming 1990. That will never happen. The future is now. I wonder what kind of wondrous things await us in the future. Edward Crow, park owner. Here at Crow Country, we can't wait to share optimism in the future with you, Douglas Pike. What's in the bin? Medicinal herbs. If you're looking for the machine chain, that's one part people took to fix a broken swan. It's on the ticket, they took it anyway. You can't reason with swan boat people. Okay. Hey Ed, want some good news? I finally found a good site for a gold mine. It's in Pará, northern Brazil. Just like we wanted, there's a disused mine there. The locals gave up on it years ago. It's still in decent shape, so it shouldn't be too much work to get it looking the part. Marv. Come on, give me something. God damn it. There's a hole in the fence. Looks like it was done with wire cutters. I think that's how Arthur got in. Seems like he cut himself on the fence. Why didn't he just, you know, shoot the entrance, you know, as you do? Right. Are you... Oh, you are literally one shot and it's gone, huh? You're like nothing, you guys. Okay. Okay, so what we've got? We got a bronze key, and that's about it. We haven't tried the other area, I guess. Just gonna try to not get too close to you. Thanks. Okay, that needs a metal panel. Well, that needs a thing. Bronze keyhole. Fan. Dabby dozy. Oh, is that just music? Oh, good. Haunted hilltop. No, yeah, we needed a place designed to be spooky in this motherfucker. Yeah, hands holding torches. Why the fuck not? Why not, indeed? Face on the wall. He's smiling at me. Gross. I couldn't move him. You know, I think he's fine where he is. Yep, okay. Okay, this looks like a person. Let's not shoot them. What are you doing? Trying to get through this door. Oh, right. Is it locked? Obviously. Is there another way around? It's possible. Right, I'll go have a look. Okay, so... Okay, lady police officer, leave her there. That's fine. Just... Oh, fuck yeah, banana peel. Please be careful on the haunted matter bookcases. Read the book titles carefully. In fact, it'd be easy if you didn't touch them at all. Alright. Entrance is blocked. I assume we need another weird face. It's a map. Ah, excellent! Map of the haunted hilltop. Yeah! We're going to go into the bone zone! Okay. Oh, it is full of it's full of bones! Okay. Okay. The deceptive serpent imprisoned for crimes against nature, 1000 BCE. What was ammo? Can I like... Nope. There's ammo in there. The Deadly Mermaid, a prison for crimes against nature, 1837. Ooh, bad noises. Not a fan of those noises. The Atlanta Globe, South American gold mine linked to local landowner reports have emerged detailing the activities of a recently revived Brazilian gold mine. Apparently the site near the north coast of the state of Pará is currently operating as one of the most profitable gold mines in the Americas. I love how the outside of the zone is Halloween fun spooky and then this is just a horrible torture room. Yeah. Selling to at least two major international companies, but why you ask, you're reporting this in the Atlanta Globe? Well, it's recently surfaced. I'm gonna close the notebook over right now. Okay. It's actually owned by local landowner businessman Edward Crow. Most of you is probably only known as the eponymous owner of the Crow Country theme park here in Atlanta, and indeed, it seems there's been some effort to cover up Mr. Crow's connection to this profitable gold mine. While eyebrows are certainly being raised at this revelation, at least we finally discovered the source of Crow's vast wealth. I mean, rich man has industry. News at 11. The big bad wolf mission to come against nature, 1810. Yep. He had a complaint from a parent about the depiction of alcohol in the mermaid cage. Well, things to complain about. I told her it's not an alcohol bottle, it's a bottle of highly corrosive acid that actually seemed to placate her. I'm not touching that Iron Maiden just yet until I've had a full look around. The violent Cyclops in Prison for Crimes Against Nature, 700 BCE. Yeah. Right. There's something underneath. Oh, it's a computer. I'm not good at computers. Access denied. Fuck you. Some kind of torture device. Open it up. There's a little button. Yes. Please tell me I didn't just die. Okay. Fun fact, Iron Maiden's gibberish. Not real. Not a thing. Okay, Iron Maidens do now exist, but, like, the idea of them as this, like, medieval torture implement was, like, an invention of people in the 1800s. They weren't actually used as torture devices, and I think there's, like, no actual records of them prior to people out of nowhere claiming that they're this old, torture device. Power switch for the far periphery element is in Tormund's office. Yes, that's the other side of the park. Yes, that means you're in the wrong place. Okay. Oh, Magnum ammo. Ooh. Paper magazine. Watch out for glass gas traps lying on the ground. You can smash them to save distance with a single handgun bullet. It won't budge. Glass gas traps. Well, I mean, it doesn't seem like I can do anything else here right now, so... Back in the trap! I just notice... The head on the fucking nope, you horrible little greasy motherfuckers. The head on the top of the Iron Maiden was a bird. That's what I was getting at. Glass balls of red caps are broken, it costs a hanger bullet, see what's inside the bottle. Ooh. Gimme! I'm gonna give each of these a kick like 3 times, because I don't actually know if they just don't drop anything, if they don't drop anything immediately, you know? Ooh. That genuinely kind of shook me, because I hadn't noticed this was here. He's hooting and hollering. Seems like 5 hoots then stops. Is it supposed to be an owl? It's shimmer like a bell. That's gonna fucking mean something. That's gonna mean something. There's no way that's not gonna mean something. Bell. Bell. Owl. Hooting and hollering. 5 hoots, then stop. That, like, there's no way that ain't gonna mean something. That's like a weirdly specific thing for it to call attention to. It's full of trash. A Granada. Okay. Is that another? Sorry, is that another? Yeah, no, I'm just gonna shoot this grenade. I mean, it worked out fine, but it probably shouldn't have. If you're doing maintenance in the Haunted Manor, trying to access the Ocean Kingdom, you need a crank handle, it's locked in the safe, the Southeast Utility Corridor. The code for the safe is something to do with the crypt. Fuck. Alright. Well, we're going into the crypt. Down we go, straight to hell! Ah, yeah. Whoa. Fuck. Estelle. Wait. North Norby. That needs to point west. You need to point east. You need to point south. I think. Oh wait, are all of them? Okay, no, you need to be pointing southwest. Yeah, you need to point southwest. You need to point south. You need to point northeast. Yeah, okay, yeah, their initials are compass points. That's why there's a compass in the floor. Cool. Why is there a... I don't think it's gonna shoot me, but I could just take it. It's stuck. It's stuck. It's stuck. It broke. I guess it was just a plastic decoration. God damn it. Here lies Ophelia, tragically drowned. Daughter, sister, human. Hmm. Actually, you know what? This is an attraction at a theme park. I guess they wouldn't actually be pointing a real shotgun at anyone. It's clearly not working, so our place will be flooded soon. Yeah, it seems like it. If any of the kids have trouble disabling the trap, you can offer this advice and read the gravestones, focus on the names, the birth dates, and death dates aren't any use to you for now. Oh, for now. Oh, fuck me. Fuck, alright. Ah, you mother! Fucking Peter! Motherfucker! Alright. I broke it! Good! Fuck it! Fucking... I left the shotgun in the submarine. Shark, 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 dolphin. Fucking... Shotgun. Submarine. Shark. 1, 2, 3, 4. X4. Dolphin. I think that's the quickest way I was never good at math. Math. What the fuck? Collection of video game tips, yeah. It's another save room. Oh, I'm guessing whenever there's a fire, it's a save room. Hey Ed, what's been going on? I finally set up the address. You can use the same with the ore. if you labeled the contents of samples of geological interest, perhaps it was like an economic research thing. Acquire shipments once a week, turn them back up to up into the mine. Hold on to your hat, we're about to become the luckiest gold miner since 1848. Very good. Field trip. Scatter the kids outside the haunted manor. Choose an older kid, get them to ring the doorbell. Nothing will happen. Laughter ensues. Then choose a younger kid and have them try. Quietly tell them the secret so they can get the door to open and press gaps. Ensure the secret is to ring the bell a specific number of times. That's why the fucking owl was hooting. I knew that. I knew the number of times it was fucking hooting was gonna matter. I should have saved. I shouldn't run up to something that has the word fatal on it and just press it. That's gonna fuck me. It's an adult magazine. Barf, no thanks. Alright, prude. Fucking bitch. Handgun ammo, cool. Oh, this is where that woman was. This is the other side of the door. Finally. Hey, how did you get inside? I went through the crypt. There was this tombstone puzzle and a shotgun and this ticking clock. Okay, I didn't ask for your life start. Yeah, fair enough. Yeah. I'm just kidding. You did good, alright? Now there's work to be done. Who are you again? Quick question. Can we clear this up? What are you doing? Yeah, I think this is the best spot. The best spot? For what? I assume he uses that elevator, so he'll see it for sure. Are you talking about Edward Crowe? Yes. Hey, would you help me out with something? Yeah, sure. What do you need? I need to clear off these tables and then lay out some documents. It won't take a minute. Oh god, are you a lawyer? For the attention of Edward Crowe. That'll do, thanks. What are those? Incident at local theme park. Parents Luke and Patricia Marshall decided to take their daughter Elaine to the local theme park for her 15th birthday. Crow Country, named for its owner, one Edward Crow, is a small amusement park found only a few miles southeast of Atlanta. It's fair to say that it's been fairly popular with the locals, but never really drew in the big crowds of some of its larger competitors. The Marshall family were walking through the haunted hilltop section of the park when Elaine became separated from her parents. Around half an hour later, Elaine reappeared. She was visibly very upset, and a patch of blood marked the front of her t-shirt. It seems Elaine had wandered into a restricted section of the park and encountered something or someone very dangerous. Yesterday, Atlanta Central Radio got a direct quote from Elaine herself speaking from her ward at Westview Hospital. There was a man in a cage. That's gonna be that guest, isn't it? Yep, that's the girl. It's a medical report. Wound across the stomach and chest, not injured to bacterial infection. Attempts to identify the nature of the bacteria are still ongoing. Attacked by a wild animal. Unsubstantiated claim the patient says she was attacked by a person. Headaches. Ongoing treatment of bacterial infection. Patient also complains of ongoing headaches and queasiness. Julie Barron, locally feared lawsuit attorney. Excellent, very good. That takes care of that. Hopefully you'll see it. While I'm here, I'm going to take a look in the cell. Did you go in? I didn't, no. I see, probably for the best. Well, catch you later. Stay out of trouble, all right? I didn't know there was a cell to be looking at. I hadn't gone to it yet. Okay. I'm also noticing the fact that Mara's name is on the save, which at least to me implies that we may be playing someone other than Mara at some stage. Oh, hello. It's a pipe. Golden tubes are falling out of the conveyor belt. Ooh, ammunition. Very good. Ooh, what's that? More tank of gasoline. Very good. Hang on, am I seeing this right? It looks like solid gold is going in there, being broken down into pieces, and then it's being artificially embedded into the rocks to make it look like gold ore. Okay, so whatever the excavation is here, is producing gold. Is producing solid, like, raw gold. Pretty fucked. Electronic keypad. Still don't really know how to get in there. Ooh, the cell. Okay, let's have a look at the cell. It's locked. Can be locked with a switch under that floor panel. It's not especially well hidden. There's a button. Let's leave that for now. Let's talk to the lawyer again. Oop, I see weaponry. Well, here we are. The instant they closed down Crow Country. It happened right here. Did you notice? It's been deep cleaned. Of course, that in itself is a form of evidence. You mean the fact they had this room cleaned is proof that something happened? Something they want to cover up? Right, no smoke without fire, as they say. No bleach without blood. Oh, that's good. I'm going to start saying that. Yeah, I mean, yeah, it is good. It's very good. It's okay. You don't need to stay. I'm sure you have places to be. Right. You're looking for Edward Crow, aren't you? Do you know where he is? I want to get into his office. It's in the northeast corner of the park, I think. Northeast, that's what you need to pass through the haunted manor. You can get the door just by ringing the bell. Once you're inside, look for a way to pass through the back wall. Right, thanks, Julie. Excellent. Yeah, let's, give this a go. The door unlocked. Simple as that. Oh, there's a medkit! It's a bed. It smells strongly of bleach. Yep. Tolman's records, March 24th. Boss and I have the storm converted into a holding cell. Pike isn't happy about it. He says we can't legally hold people here, even if they've committed a crime within the park. No, it's not for criminals. Boss brings the guest up here. I mean, if they're trying to cover this up, the fact that they've left all this fucking documentation around is the bad... They're not doing a crime. It's not a great cover-up, is it? If there's all this fucking documentation lying around. If they've got all the... Like, a full... If you could piece together through, like, very blunt documents exactly what happened, they've kind of fucked up the job of covering it up. He wants to run some tests. Says it'll be much quicker if he doesn't have to travel down to the lab each time. I think it's a very bad idea to bring the guest up to the surface, especially while the park is still open. Almost immediately, I'm proven right. A girl named Elaine Marshall finds her way into the holding cell and counts the guest. She's injured, taken to hospital. Boss is forced to close the park. I fear this is not the end, but the beginning. Okay, cool. Here's my guess. Whatever that route is... The guest is something from the roots, whatever the roots are. And something about the roots is like, allow, like, oh wait, is that another map? Cool. Something about the roots. Like, allows people to, something about the roots, like, produces gold. Something about the excavation produces gold. The guest is some kind of monster spawned from the roots. Oh! Oh, that's... Oh! Oh! The... Oh! Bad to look at, that thing. Yeah. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Hey, little guy. You're my favorite. Can I shoot you? Hang on, can I shoot you? Can I shoot you? I have to try. That looks like... Okay, no, I just went through here. Okay. Like something out of Mad God? Yeah, a little bit, actually, yeah. Yeah, that weird torso beast wasn't great. Is that supposed to be a ghost? Is that like a holo... Are these like holograms? I mean... I know that... The fuck? I know there was, like, hologram-style things. on, like, in, like, Disneyland and stuff. Like, I think, like, in the Haunted Mansion specifically. But, like, I'm pretty sure that's, like, a trick with, like, mirrors and glass. I don't think you could just have a hologram just there. There's a vampire sleeping inside. Look closer. He's not real, obviously. Oh, okay. Fucking piece of shit. This game can go fuck itself. This game... That's what you get for trying to scare me, you fucking bitch. This game's a fucking asshole. It's fucking unfair. It's stupid. This game's fucking dumb. Oh, those tall boxes can have things in them. A swift and sudden end. Take the book. I mean... I mean... Yeah, alright. What did you... What the fuck? I looked down for a second, looked at me, you were dead. I pulled out a book, that was titled Swift and Sudden End and got basically exactly what I deserved for doing that. To be fair. Can't hold that one against the game. Especially given that I'd gotten a note earlier. Especially given that I'd literally been given, like, gotten a note earlier that warned me to pay attention to the names on the books and not do that. Like, the game literally, like, warned me not to do that as well. That's entirely on me. That, yeah, that's on Ethan, that one. That's on Ethan. That's very much on Ethan. Alright. Angry at myself. Okay. Stupid. Okay, I'm saving again. Just in case I fucking do that again. Alright. Nope, I meant to reload, not fire. Oh, wait, take the map. Why is that in a fucking theme park? They don't need- if they're installing shit like that here, they don't need, like... weird guest thing to cause problems. Come on, big horrible thing. One, two, three, four, five. Handgun bullets. My own fault. It's me being dumb. Yep. It's not real, obviously. You piece of shit! Alright. That's a deep hole. Adramelech, the Undying, blamed for many deaths between 10:20 and 11:15. Just put my hand in there, not happening. Oh, come on, be James Sunderland about it. There's a hole in the middle of it. 10:20 and 11:15. Oh, wait, I don't have a thing to wind the clock with, but I'm guessing that's... Okay, it's not gonna go near that. Common remedies and antidotes. Ah! Inconsequential. Nothing happened. Fucking this game. Alright, this game, you know, this game's got a sense of humor about it. I approve. Hello? You came back. Who is this? I'll admit I'm glad to see you're up and about. Oh, the tenacity of youth. it's gone. Hey, you know what? I'm calling it right now. We are... I think we're playing as that girl. As a like, I think that's who we're playing as. Yeah, fuck it. See what the bird has for me. Yeah, give me another fortune. Crank Hand is locked in the safe. Fucking excellent, thank you. Pulling of the pin by G-Nade. It's a grenade! Genuinely thought I might just fucking throw it at me, to be honest. Shooting all of these is anything. Regular winding, but please don't attempt it with the wrong tool. Melody of the Dead. Oh! Oh! In order to open these, Song in a Cage, I can play the names of these portrait, these pictures on here. Boy, I'll use my mushroom magic to grant you a wish. Tell me, what is it that you wish? What's that? You want to improve the range of your flamethrower? To each their own, I guess. Wait, you don't even have a flamethrower? No wish for you. Okay, well, I guess we can get a fucking flamethrower range increase when we get a flamethrower. Dead. Cool. D E E dead. Okay, that's just the way, and then Fade is the other one. Fade. I'm gonna write down about the mushroom guy. Haunted Mansion, Mushroom, Boy, Flamethrower, Upgrade. Talk to the mushroom again. Fucking... little mushroom. He's just a little guy. He's just a little guy. Okay. D E dead. Fit through if I wanted to. Let's go through. He's just a little guy, you know? Okay. Y'all getting a bit beaky on this here. It's empty. Well, shucks. Watch out for my explosives on the ground. Yeah, I'm watching. Oh, we're over here! I had completely not noticed that trap. That trap would have 100% got me if that thing hadn't walked into it. Not strongly pitching yet, this is still dark. Stay on the floor, what were they trying to clean up? What are you? I don't think it's locked. It's gasoline again. I think there must be a flamethrower if there's so many of these, like, things of gasoline, you know? Like, it explains why we keep finding fucking gasoline if there's a flamethrower. Main of staff, there's a button behind the panel on the back of the wooden crow house. You can use it to access the controls of the big animatronic crow. Oh, sick. We can fuck with that big crow. Excellent. Very good. The door's stuck. It's empty. Cool. What's this? Okay, we need a crank for that, gasoline for that, a chain for that. Understood. Don't know why it was drawn by a child, but okay. Are you alright, man? My head. I flew up. Hey, it's alright, don't worry about it. Can I ask, did something happen to you? It only grazed me. I thought it'd be fine. I don't even know what it was. My head is pounding. My stomach is... Alright. You were attacked. I feel dizzy. I have something that might make you feel better, at least for a little while. You should take this. Thanks. I think that actually helped. I'm so rude. What was your name? Mara. You are, like, tall, woman. Thanks, Mara. I'm woman. Woman Crow. I'm Natalie Crow. What are you doing here, Mara? I'm actually looking for your father, for Edward Crow. What on earth do you want with father? You filed a missing persons report, didn't you? Yes, I did. You're who they sent? Fucking rude. Yeah, I'm Agent Mara Forrest. But you're so... What? Yeah, okay, it's cause she's widow. You're so fucking widow! Detective Harrison James, he couldn't make it, problem with his car. So they sent you instead? Yep. This is your father's office? He's not in there. I've been out here for hours and I haven't heard a sound. Be that as it may, I'd still have to take a look inside. Do you know how to get in? That's going to be difficult. You'll need the key. It's a big fancy gold one. Gold key, got it. And you'll have to turn off the electrified door handle. How do I do that? No idea, it wasn't electrified the last time I was here. Father must have only recently had it installed. Why? What's he hiding in there? Yeah, good fucking question. I'm sorry, Mom, I'm still not feeling great. Right, of course, I'll leave you alone. You're kind. Cool, thanks. Sweet nothing. Sweet fuck all. More of Tommen's records. Alarm triggered at 2:15 a.m. Two more guests appeared in the... appeared in the pool room. This time I made sure the cameras were running so we have proof. They came out of the pool. They're worse than the first. Broken, wrong shape, falling apart. I feel heartless describing them so, but I have no other words for them. But I said we wouldn't be able to move them like we did with the first guest. He spent 23 minutes trying to talk to them. Then he shot them both. It's empty. These are all fucking empty, dude. Oh, shit. I meant to reload and I threw a grenade instead. Hey, grenade! I'm enjoying this. This game's fun. This game's pretty cool. The fairy, she's facing the other way. It's a pulley, I think it's removing the curtain. I don't like that. That thing in the chair, not a fan. So if made it, please varnish the Ocean Kingdom storage door, or else switch it on entirely. It's meant for me, the old wood's starting to crumble. It's not exactly fire safe. Oh yeah, because stairs would be too much, wouldn't it? I don't like, that's going to attack me. Like, just look at it. Apple core. Just look at it, that thing's going to... Okay, I mean, I'm now noticing there's actually more of them. Is this one dead? Oh god, it's dead. I suppose that's all there is to say. Is this one dead? Did somebody kill it, or did it just die? I mean, this one's... that thing. It's got that thing running towards me. That's got some real little bastard energy, that thing. Hello? Listen, I had no idea what the roots were for. How could I have known? What roots? What are you talking about? There are 7 in total, and I cut them down, cut them open. You cut them open? What? All but one. We left one intact. For posterity, we thought. What a farce. Okay, so... damaged... whatever the roots are. And it caused... monsters to appear. Fuck, it did it again! That's gonna... I could just feel in my bones that's gonna fucking get me frequently there. Next thing, throw grenades. Yeah, I probably could have used that stick, to be honest. Right, go to the utility corridor.
Do you hear the voices too?
Quit it. It's a couch. Sit in it. It's comfortable, but I don't like sitting in it. Crank on the southeast utility corridor. North, south, east. So be back there then, right? Oh, you know what? We should go see if we can fuck with that big crow now that we know that there's a thing to interact with in the back. This mushroom boy wasn't open before, was he? I shouldn't have to say this, but for your safety and my sanity, please do not eat any of the mushrooms. Granada. Thank you. It's blocking the way. I could easily move it. It's the Mushroom King. There's a button on his head. I invited Amanita Fallowides to dinner. Unless I find myself dining alone, I'm afraid the death cap will be thrown to the pigs. Okay, you know what? Before I try this, I'm gonna go save. Cause I'm 100% gonna get myself killed. I can feel it in my bones. Alright. I can feel it in my bones. You know what? I think I'm gonna try and solve this puzzle, and then go see what I can do with the big bird, and then I think I'm gonna call it for tonight. But I think I might just continue this. Like I think I might just play more of this. This game's pretty cool. I was kind of expecting to like play it once and then like not like worry about it ever again. But I'm actually. I find myself surprised by how much I'm enjoying this game. Alright, so Bushel, Morrel, and Shiitake are all fine. Invited Amita. No. I invited Lepanita. Amanita. Amanita, and then an R. Now I need to find the Mochella. One of them. Iceman and the poor dude, I'll just figure out if I ate the right mushrooms. Excellent, very good. Okay. Let's go poke the big bird. Oh. Hello. Excuse me, miss, you really shouldn't be wandering around here. Why not? It's not safe. Would you like me to escort you out? Are you a police officer? Police Detective Harrison James. I was supposed to be here hours ago, but some kid broke into my car this morning. Little punk slashed my tires, too. They look okay to me. No, they slashed my car tires. I had to borrow the bike because I couldn't use my car. Uh-huh. I didn't catch your name. Oh, sorry, I'm Mara. Right, that's the car up front, the A5 Fiesta. Yeah, how did you know? I met your boyfriend who said he's waiting for you. Oh my god, he's not my- never mind, it doesn't matter. You're blushing. I'm not. Shut up. Actually, Mara, maybe you can help me. I was supposed to meet up with a woman, a Miss Natalie Crow. You haven't seen her around, have you? As far as I know, she's early 20s, blonde hair. Nope, no idea, sorry. That's okay, I thought I'd ask just in case. Need to go find Miss Crow. I'm gonna ask you to go back to your car, okay? It's not safe here, you need to go home. She was just on my way out. Glad to hear it, you'll be safe now, okay? Yeah, we are 100% that girl who got injured originally. I really didn't think he was gonna show up. This kind of looks like... Yeah. Crow walking sequence. Nothing happened, I think it's out of power. Aw, oh, that's a shame. Ah, that's presumably for the battery. Hello? The first guest emerged in the pool 2 years ago. I've been thinking it must have been on purpose. The timing, I mean. 1988, it must have been some sort of intersection, a critical pivoting point, if you will. Late enough that we've developed the necessary infrastructure. Early enough that we've... Well, early enough so as to not be too late, I suppose. Let's go to the next set and there's a save point, which I actually think would probably actually be the, yeah, that utility corridor. Okay. I mean, to be fair, the guy, the officer is entirely correct. It is wildly unsafe here. Tombstone the year Selena died. Oh, wait! Selena's in the crypt. Estelle, Norbert, Selena, 1872. Got a crank. Excellent, very good. Okay. I don't drink coffee, good thing too, since I don't think it's working. Okay. Where's the where's that fire drum? There it is. Okay, cool. But yeah, so I think I'm gonna call that there. But yeah, no, this game's I'm liking this. Like, I'm liking this a lot more than I was expecting, honestly. It's got like a, you know what, it's not like, I'm not like sat here like, oh my god, I'm so frightened, I can't deal with it. But it's also, you know, it's made me jump a few times. It's got, it's almost like a Halloween kind of vibe where it's like, it's not scary, but it's spooky in a fun way, and I enjoy that. I think that's partially helped by the art style. And also, again, just the sense of humor. The main character's got a good sense of humor. But yeah, so I will be streaming tomorrow. Because as I mentioned at the very start of the stream, I am now off work for the better part of a month. So I will be back with some more of this tomorrow. And then probably Sunday. Yeah. I hope you enjoyed this stream. But, as mentioned, that is gonna be it for me for tonight. Game's good. This was supposed to be an impressions, so there will be a link to the Steam store page of the game in the description if you watch the VOD on YouTube afterwards. But yeah, no, this game's fucking rad. I like this game. Bye.